Welcome to the session. Topic of this session is elements of firm investment analysis. Basically, the firm investment analysis is help in assessing the financial performance of the project or new proposal or new proposed project. And actually, we need to put the cost and the benefit streams of a new proposed project into a model firm plan or patent firm plan in order to assess the financial performance of the new project. And for that purpose, we need to understand the elements of the firm investment analysis. And to understand the financial performance of the new project, actually we have undertaken the model firm plan, or the size of that firm plan is 5 hectares, and the farmers or is following the mixed farming system. Actually, in the new proposal, the farmers want to introduce the two new crops, the jowar fodder, the sorghum fodder in the the kharif season, and in sunflower in the rabi season. So basically, two new crops the farmer want to introduce in his farm, and actually. And then actually we want to measure the financial performance of that new proposal, that is a new proposed crops in the farm. What will be the financial scenario after implementing the two new crops? So that's why in this session basically we are going to understand the elements of farm investment analysis. So, learning objective of this session is to discuss a model format for the investment analysis, and basically that include the most common features that are of significance in agricultural project analysis. So, basically we want to understand a model format or model firm plan, which are commonly available, commonly used by the large category of the farmers in the country like India. And basically, once we finalize the component of the projects like crops and livestock in the farming system or in the new proposed farming system for a model farm, actually, and then we can proceed to prepare the firm investment analysis. So basically, there are 4 principal elements of the firm investment analysis, like firm resource use, firm production, firm input, firm budget. So we will be discussing in detail about these 4 elements of firm investment analysis. And the first the element is the firm resources, and there are sub elements, various sub component of the firm resource use, like land use, land use calendars, and the labor use, annual labor requirement for crops operation, and for every crop we have to estimate the labor requirement for 1 hectare, then labor distribution by crops and month per hectare. So actually here again we have to calculate the labors for the different crops month wise, and then labor requirement for the different crops month wise we have to prepare. Then we have to also estimate about the hired labor requirement for crops and month. Then we also estimate about the off farm labor. So these are the different components actually we should include in the model farm account as a farm resource. Then second component is the farm production. So again there are many activities in the farm, and livestock is also one of the activities of the production process, or that is a kind of farm production. So here we have to have the information about the crop and pastures, like yield of the and carrying capacity of the crops, the crop and pasture production, total production, And then in case of the livestock, we have the herd projection. We need to have the herd consumption, purchase and sales over the period of time. Then herd productivity, feeding period and daily ration, and then feeding requirement and production, the yield per animals. And then after have the information about the crop and livestock, then we have to also do the valuation. So valuation we can do at the farm gate prices. So we have to calculate the value of the production of the crops and livestock. So these are the different subcomponents under the farm production. Then we have the farm input. So here, you know, there are different activities. Mainly there are three farm inputs. One is the investment. So here the physical investment in the machineries or building, and here also we have to consider, we have to take into account the foreign exchange component. Then value of the investment also we have to do. Then we have the operating expenditures for running the farm or the crop and livestock. Then also we have to add the incremental working capital that is also required in the as a farm input. Then last component, the farm budget. So here we have to calculate the farm budget. So basically in the farm investment analysis, we compare the, you know, the results or the incremental benefit of the project without the project and with the projects, then only we can get the net benefit. So here there are different components of our budget. So we have to calculate the budget without the project, with the project, and then we have to calculate the net benefit before financing, and then we have to include the debt services, then net benefit after financing, then we in the last we have the cash positions or net benefits. So here in the last we can compare the position of the firm. Basically we can compare the two conditions of the firm, like without the project and with projects, and here we can calculate the net incremental benefit of the project. Now we will go into the details about different elements of the farm investment analysis. So before we go for the farm investment analysis elements, let us first have some assumption about the, you know, basic accounting procedures and how to enter the information or data in the model farm plan. So the first assumption is that we should assume that the every transaction fall at the end of the accounting period. That is, basically we consider that the initial investment take place at the end of the year one of the project. So here argument is that, you know, though the investment take place in the whole years, you know, maybe sometimes in a week, few weeks, or in a few months, or in the whole the year, but we consider that investment is taking place at the end of the year. And then the operating expenditure, that is also very important part of the. So here we include the we enter the operating expenditure at the beginning of the cropping season. So here argument is that whatever the operating expenditure required, we should make available at the beginning of the year. And then there is a third component is incremental working capital, and we should enter this detail of the incremental working capital at the end of the preceding year. So basically for the following year we want to make the arrangement a provision of the working capital, and so actually we make that provision at the end of the preceding year. Then basically in the when we talk about the accounting convention, we consider that at the end of the project, the incremental working capital for each year is added together algebraically and taken out of the project as part of the residual value, that is basically written on working capital. Now we'll move to the element of the firm investment analysis. And when we talk about the first element is the farm resource use. So in that, land is the most important. We can say it is the first step to determine the land use, and basically we want to determine how the land use will be there. So in our case, you know, we have taken the example that there is a land use for a mixed farm under an agricultural development project, and the total area is 5 hectare, which has to be allocated to different crops, and there is also we need to allocate the land for the house plot. And in the first year, the land use is in accordance with the accounting convention, that is suggested that there would remain unchanged in the year one of the project. So actually, in the year one, we assume that there will be no change in the cropping pattern, because in the year one, we assume that there will be the investment activities like purchasing the inputs, purchasing of the machinery if required, or the building. So in the first year, we do not bring the change in the cropping pattern. And in the year two, basically, we introduce the crops, like in our case, we are introducing two crops, jowar fodder in the kharif season and sunflower in the rabi season. So here you can see the change in the land use pattern, and here we have the 5 hectare land of the farm size, and the farmer is following the mixed farming, and so here the area is allocated. So in case of the without project, if there is no project, so the area is allocated under different crops like maize, paddy, and there is no jowar fodder in the without project. Area under jowar fodder is not there. And then soybean, wheat, lentil, mustards, and sunflower is also not there in the without project. And the brashim fodder is also there. So there are total, 5 hectare land, and out of 5 hectare land, 0.5 hectare land is allocated for the house plot. So total the net cultivable area available is the 4.5 hectares. So I know, because there are two seasons, so the total cropped area is become 9 hectares. So actually this 4.5 hectare in the kharif season and 4.5 hectare in the rabi season, so it become a 9 hectare. So in the year one, there is no change in the cropping pattern as we have assumed in the accounting convention. And in the year two, year three, and year four, year five, we have introduced the jowar fodder. So actually, the area of the maize, there was a two hectare without the project. So of that 2 hectare, 0.5 hectare we have taken from the maize, and that have been allotted to the jowar fodder. In case of the rabi season also, we have allotted the 0.5 hectares and the sunflower, that has been taken from the the mustard, 0.5 hectare from the mustard, that area has been allotted to the sunflower. And this second component of the farm resource use is the labor use, and actually we have to work out labor requirement of the farm, and for each individual crops and for each livestock enterprises in each year, and that also we have to work out season wise, like rabi season requirement or kharif season requirement. And actually it is also desirable to work out the labor requirement by operation and by month also. So we have to prepare the requirement for different, like sowing, weeding, the harvesting, how much labor is requirement, and then also we have to calculate the labor requirement month wise. So once the total hired labor has been worked out, the requirement has been worked out, it is allocated among the different various crops and livestock enterprises to include in the proper category of the operating expenditure. So here it is the format for recording the operation wise labor requirement for crop. It is given the mandate, and so this is the format we can use, like for land preparation, how much labor is required, the sowing and transplanting, and nursery raising, fertilization, and the irrigation, weeding, hoeing. So these are the different operations of the for the crop. And here we can estimate, we can allocate the requirement, without the project what is the requirement, and with the project year wise we can identify the labor requirement. And this is the format to record the information about the labor requirement in the monthly basis. So here again we can identify the labor requirement in mandate per hectare. So you know, from July, August, September, October, November, December, then January, February, March, up to June. So for every month, all 12 months, we have to estimate the labor requirement for different crops without the project, with the project in year 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and for different crops like maize, paddy, and jowar fodder, and then the in case of the rabi, the mustard and wheat. So all the crops we have to estimate the labor requirement monthly wise. Then we will move to the farm production, that is the second So here again, the after determination of the use of the land and labor resources on the farm pattern or model farm, the next task is to assess the projected farm production. So like we have the crop and we have the livestock, so for crop, how we can assess the farm production? The total crop production is basically we can obtain by multiplying the area under each crop in each year with the average yield per hectare of that respective crop. And for example, our farm is the max farm, so here the requirement of feed for the livestock will be met from the crop production on the farm. So it is detected from the total production of the crop. So basically, because the livestock is also a part of the production, so whatever the feeding requirement for livestock, that is we are producing from the crops, so that is basically deducted from the total farm production. And actually the net production available for sale and for farm family consumption is worked out here. So after detecting the requirement for the livestock, and we calculate the net production available for the soil or for available for the farm family consumption. So actually, first we have to estimate the yield of the different crops. So without the project and with the projects, for yield of the different crops we can estimate. And then we have to estimate the crop production by multiplying the yield with the the area under the crops. So we have estimated here the total production without the project and with the project. Like we have the crops like maize, paddy, and the jowar fodder, soybean, wheat, lentil, mustard, sunflower, and barsim fodder. So here we have calculated the production by multiplying the yield with the area under different crop. And here again the we have to also calculate about the feed consumption. So how much feed is required of the for livestock, how much jowar fodder is required, how much barsim fodder is required, that we have to calculate with and without project also. And then we have to calculate the net production after detecting the fodder requirement for the and the livestock purpose. So we have calculated the net production which is available for the sale and for the farm family consumption. And in case of the calculating the livestock production, actually we can calculate it, we can assess the livestock production during each year. It's for that purpose we have to know the, we have to understand the its composition, how many types of the the livestock are there, then purchase and sale in different years to be projected. So we have to project the how many animals we will be purchasing, how many animals will be selling in the years to come. And it is a basically complex procedure or complex test, but it could be achieved with through knowledge of the future facilities to be created in the project regarding the feed and fodder. And we can, by considering the demand and market infrastructure for the product shell. So here it is the the format for recording the livestock production is given. So the first we have to see the livestock numbers and at the beginning of the year. So here we have different types of livestock like cows, so different breed wise cow we have to see the number, then buffaloes breed wise again, then bullock, then he buffaloes, the young stock, and that hyper, the heifer, the young stock, and others. And then there are, if any other लाइफ स्टॉक स्पीसीज अवेलेबल लाइक गोट एंड शीप वी हैव टू एस्टिमेट एंड देन देन वी हैव टू ऑल्सो सी द परचेज ऑफ द एनिमल्स इन द प्रोजेक्ट ड्यूरेशंस लाइक काउज बफलो बुलोक दही बफलो अदर लाइफ स्टॉक स्पीसीज इफ यू आर गोइंग टू परचेज इन द प्रोजेक्ट पीरियड दैट वी हैव टू एस्टिमेट्स वी हैव टू प्रोजेक्ट एंड देन वी हैव टू ऑल्सो प्रोजेक्ट द सेल of the animals like cows, buffalo, bullock and different types of the animals then and here also we need to have information about some technical coefficients related to the livestock production like calving rate and cows and calving rate and buffalo the calf mortality rate in case of the cow calf mortality in case of the buffalo then adult mortality in case of the cow and buffalo so actually we can project the real figure of the availability of the animals so you know this technical coefficient is very much required and we need to have complete knowledge about the technical coefficient then the valuation of the farm production is also important things and after the estimating the production we need to value the farm production so here we can consider the farm gate prices of the items which are to be obtained which are projected for the valuation of the farm production and that is crops and livestock so here we can take the information basically related to the price by seeing the by observing in the field or also we can have some forecasting we can forecast the prices or the money value of the crops and the livestock and sometimes we can have the future prices that can be forecasted observing the past trend we can forecast the future prices and then the value of the crops and livestock product could be determined by multiplying the production by the unit prices and thereof so here the we can find out the values we can work out the values by multiplying the production by the prices unit prices and in case of the farm production incremental residual value is also important basically it is in the last year of the farm investment analysis the incremental residual or terminal value of the farm is included that is in terms of the salvage value of the capital assets any after you know basically sometimes we get the junk value after the life of the machinery or building is over they have some values that we have to include here then we have to also include the working capital then also we have to include the value of the items that have a substantial or useful life remaining at the end of the project life of that particular machinery or particular infrastructures buildings or farm shed or animal sheds so that we have to include in the residual value that is incremental residual value and then farm input is another component in the farm investment analysis and so after the production estimation and the estimates of the input cost is prepared and there are three component in farm input one is the investment another is the operating expenditure third is the working capital and basically the investment when we talk about the investment basically investment cost for a project means it includes the expenditure required on assets such as machines equipments the tractor plow like cultivator we have to purchase then we have the investment on the land improvement activities like cleaning of the forest drainage system irrigation channel and leveling and then we have the investment on constructions like farm building the well fencing then we have the investment on the purchase of the livestock so it is convenient if investment cost is estimated on per unit basis so you know the better to have the estimates of the you know investment on the per unit of the machinery or per building or you know per animals that we can do and then operating expenditure is another part of the farm investment or farm input component of the farm investment analysis and operating expenditure is to be considered for the crops and livestock equipment etc and actually The here in case of the investment analysis, we do not include the depreciation cost. Basically, we consider here discounted cash flow of the we considered complete life of the in the machineries or buildings. This and actually we consider in the investment analysis the complete project life. So there is no need to include the depreciation cost here. And you know there are different items under the operating expenditure, like in case of the crop, so we have to include the cost of the labor, the seed, fertilizer and pesticides. In case of the livestock, feed, fodder, mineral mixture, vaccine cost. And then in case of the for equipments, like we have to include the repair and maintenance expenditure, the fuel and lubricant requirement for running the machinery. And actually, if you are using the family labors or the seed which are produced at the farm, for that actually we can value the family labor and seed at the farm gate prices. And then third input, third part of the farm input is the incremental working capital, but it is required to work out the incremental working capital needed in the farm, model farm. And in incremental working capital needed for a year can be worked out as some product proportion of the incremental operating expenditure for the following year. In the context of our farming situation, where crop and livestock enterprises are produced continuously, we may consider that the 40% or 50% of incremental operating expenditure of the following year as the incremental working capital. And farm budget is the last component of the investment in the analysis. So farm budget is prepared from the detail of the resource use, the production and the input for the pattern of model farm. And purpose of preparing the farm budget is to estimate the incremental net benefits arising on the farm. And basically we can calculate this incremental net benefit with the by comparing the two different project, with project and without project. So first we have to calculate the net benefit without the project, and then we have to calculate the net benefit with the project, and then we can compare the net benefit without the project and with the project, and the difference between these two is the incremental net return or net benefits. So here the stream of net benefits can be calculated as the difference between the inflows and outflow year by year. And we can sum up this session that the major elements of farm investment analysis are farm resource use, that is basically land and labor, then farm production, crops and livestock, then inputs. There are three types of inputs, and the increment residual value. We have to, these are the different components of farm investment analysis. Then we have to prepare the farm budget, and it is prepared on the basis of the detailed workouts for the with respect to the resource use, the production and input for the model farm. And the purpose of preparing the farm budget is to estimate the incremental net benefits as a result of the project. And for this purpose, we need to compare the net benefit without the project with the with the project. So from the size of the incremental net benefit, we can take decision, we can take the decisions about the financial performance of the new proposed project. Thank you very much.